A proper road race, and in the true meaning of the word. That was how Mr. Monaco, the late great Graham Hill, once described this iconic event. The cars we drive have come a long way in the intervening half century, but still we race on those same public roads beside the Mediterranean Sea. There's no victory more coveted than that of the Monaco Grand Prix. The astonishing Circuit de Monaco is, for all intents and purposes, virtually unchanged since its inaugural race back in 1929. The faster cars of today, though, ensure the 19 corners past the casino and along the seafront remain as thrilling as ever. A 2.1-mile lap here takes us around an entire country, yet never more than inches from the race-ending barriers. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Valtteri Bottas lines up on pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Sainz, Lando Norris, and Ricciardo, Verstappen, Vettel, Stroll, and more. Ocon, Gasly, Nobuharu Matsushita, and Tsunoda. Giovinazzi, Mick Schumacher, Robert Schwartzman, and George Russell, Mazepin, and Nicholas Latifi. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going. Internal combustion engine. Let's try and keep the revs down. Early upshifts, later downshifts. Okay, gap ahead is 10.1 seconds. It looks critical. Find somewhere to retire as soon as possible. We can't risk you carrying on with this race.
Mercedes have pulled off a great victory here today. Anthony Davidson, a resounding victory today. What set them apart from the rest?
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment to really execute the team's plan to perfection. A shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners today. The updated driver standings. After today's performance, Valtteri Bottas secures the championship lead. Some amazing talent out on the track today, but Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Well, there's no question in my mind, it has to go to George Russell. What a performance. He's got every right to be proud of what he accomplished out there today.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
Bad luck out there today. Let's talk about it. Your car seemed to be having some problems there. What was the cause? You got really unlucky out there today. Who's to blame for that failure? Great. Well, that's everything.
Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix.
Thank you.
It's time to remind ourselves of our top three.
Bottas,
Hamilton,
and Charles Leclerc.
Well, that wraps up...
Qualifying pace didn't put you at the front of the grid. Well, it must be incredibly frustrating to not make it to the end of a race due to car issues. What went wrong out there? Your teammates seem to struggle to capitalise on opportunities to overtake. Any idea why that is? Great. Well, that's everything.
Good afternoon and welcome to Baku. This was the arena, if you think back to 2017, of one of the most eventful races of modern history, with controversy behind the safety car, last second overtakes, and a historic podium for Williams and for Lance Stroll. So let's find out what lies in store for us this year. It's time for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. The Baku City Circuit measures roughly 6 kilometers and is made up of 20 corners and 2 DRS zones. The circuit winds around the narrow city, through the old town, and even brushes against the city's medieval walls. However, as beautiful as the setting is, this track is also a ferocious technical challenge, where the smallest of mistakes could lead to catastrophic consequences for all of our drivers. Alongside me once again for coverage of today's race, it's none other than the great Anthony Davidson. Now, I want to talk to you about Valtteri Bottas. That was a great win in the last race. Can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
It's always nice to come into a Grand Prix weekend on a high, but your expectations are based much more on your practice and qualifying runs. So it's the momentum from those sessions that they'll be hoping to carry into the race today.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Good job yesterday from Valtteri Bottas. The fence starts from pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Leclerc, Ricciardo, Lando Norris, and Verstappen, Sainz, Moore, Vettel, and George Russell, Stroll, Giovinazzi, Esteban Ocon, and Tsunoda, Latifi, Schwartzman, Nobuharu Matsushita and Pierre Gasly, Mazepin and Mick Schumacher. Now, it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track.
bad for a number two driver.
Absolutely fantastic. It's a brilliant result. Well done.
It's never an easy race here in Azerbaijan. There's drama around every corner, but they've come through to take a brilliant win here today. Ant, talk to me. What do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
I'd say it was down once again to good, consistent driving, nailing the corners, working to the track conditions, and perfecting the team's strategies. They got all of these things right today, and the results speak for themselves.
Red Bull put up an outstanding fight for the front position today, and it's great to see it paid off for them. They do so much for the sport that you can't help but be delighted by today's race win. Let's have a look then at the driver's standings. More points for Valtteri Bottas, further solidifying his lead at the top of the table. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
I have to give it to Moore. They pushed and pushed and found some fantastic performance. It was just a pleasure to watch.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, a strong weekend from Red Bull this time out, and they improve their position in the championship. I'm equal parts exhausted and elated with this weekend of Formula One. Be sure to join us for the next one.
great workout there today. Let's have your thoughts. You performed better than last weekend. What changed? It's safe to say you're smashing everyone's expectations, isn't it? Great. Well, that's everything.
Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend.